This video is going to be about multiplying radical expressions. And I just want to cover most of the kinds of multiplication problems you're going to have when you're dealing with radicals. So here's the first one. I've got the square root of 3 times the square root of 12, and you've probably seen something like this already. So I've got these two square roots, and I've got a rule that tells me that I can multiply the radicands, the numbers underneath the radical sign, and put everything under one square root. So I'm going to have 3 times 12, and that's 36. And then, since 36 is a perfect square, I'll just write that as a 6. Here's another problem. I've got 2 times the square root of 10 times 3 times the square root of 5. And I first start out by multiplying the 2 times the 3. That's going to give me a 6. And then I multiply the two radicands, so 10 times 5 is 50. Now, 50, of course, is 25 times 2, so I can break this down into two factors, and one will be a perfect square. So let's see, I'll have 6 times the square root of 25 times 2. And then, since the square root of 25 is 5, I'm going to have 6 times 5 times the square root of 2, and 6 times 5 is 30. So I'll have 30 times the square root of 2. Now, I've been doing all these, I've done these problems, and the next ones I'm going to do are just going to have numbers in them. But remember, you can also, that whatever works for these will also work for variables. So here's some more problems. I've got 4 times the square root of 3, and that's going to multiply this expression, the square root of 3 minus 2. So I'm basically just distributing this 4 times the square root of 3. So 4 times the coefficient here, which is a 1, is going to be 4 times 1 is 4. And the square root of 3 times the square root of 3 will give me the square root of 9. And then I'm going to multiply 4 times the square root of 3 times negative 2, and that will give me negative 8 times the square root of 3. And then, of course, I want to take this square root of 3 and turn it square root of 9 and take that square root, which is just a 3. So I'll have 4 times the square root of 9, or 4 times 3. So that will be 12 minus 8 times the square root of 3. This problem is, it looks similar to the kinds of binomial multiplications we ran into where you foiled them. And we're going to foil this as well. So I've got this 3 times the square root of 5 times the square root of 5. I'll multiply those two together, my first terms. That's going to give me 3 times the square root of 25. I'll multiply my outside terms. That will give me 3 times the square root of 5 times 2, so that'll give me 6 times the square root of 5. My inside terms will give me negative 4 times the square root of 5, so it's minus 4 times the square root of 5. And my last terms, negative 4 and 2, will give me a negative 8. So now, what I want to do is simplify this down, because there's a bit of work I can still do. So 25 is a perfect square, so instead of writing the square root of 25, I'll write a 5. That will give me 3 times 5 is 15. My two middle terms both have a square root of 5 in them, so I can subtract 6 times the square root of 5. From that, I'll subtract 4 times the square root of 5. That will give me 6 minus 4 is 2. So 2 times the square root of 5. And I've got a minus 8 over here. Then since I've got a 15 and a negative 8, I can combine them. So my final answer is going to be, let's see, 15 minus 8 is 7, plus 2 times the square root of 5. And one final one. the square root of 7 plus 2 times the square root of 7 minus 2. Now this is kind of neat, so watch what happens. Foiling this, the square root of 7 times the square root of 7 will give me the square root of 49. You know, if you want to just write the square root of 7 times square root of 7 equals 7, you can do that as well. But I just want to go through this step by step. And then I've got the square root of 7 times negative 2. So that will give me negative 2 times the square root of 7. I've got a positive 2 and the square root of 7. So that will give me plus 2 times the square root of 7. And I've got 2 times negative 2 will give me a negative 4. Now, let's see what I can do with this. The square root of 49 is 7. Negative 2 times the square root of 7 and positive 2 times the square root of 7 will cancel each other out. So my middle term is going to disappear. And the only thing I have left now is minus 4. And then, of course, 7 minus 4 just equals 3. Okay, so when you have a multiplication problem like this, if you take a look at it, I've got basically two identical expressions, except that in one case I've got a plus sign, in one case I've got a minus sign. When you see something like that, you can even do a shortcut. You can take the first part of each expression and just write the radicand. Since we're multiplying a number times, we're squaring a square root. That's going to give us the radicand, which is 7. And then you can write a negative sign, square the last two terms. That'll give you negative 4. And then just combine them together, and that'll be it. Okay, so take a good look at this and make sure you understand what's going on here. That's about it for now. Good luck. I'll see you next time.